So I just finished watching The Mark of Gideon, and it was bad. It was really bad. This was Spock's brain bad. This was And the Children Shall Lead bad. And I'm getting really frustrated because I want to finish this season. I want to finish this series. I want to continue doing this project. But season 3 has just been awful. I think I've had, maybe one or two episodes that I've actually really enjoyed, and the rest of them are just bad. This episode in particular, I think, reached a whole new level, where Spock's brain was funny bad. It was MST3K bad. This was Daredevil bad. This was Green Lantern bad. As in, you're scratching your head, why did they make these decisions? And I'm talking like from a writing standpoint. Basically, in this one, Kirk has to go and beam down to this planet to be a diplomat and talk to these people. And when he beams down, he has actually just beamed back into the Enterprise, and everybody's gone. And that was interesting. I was like, okay, what are we doing here? Parallel universe, godlike aliens, what's going on? Well, it turns out he meets this beautiful woman on this ship. And here's one of the things that really stood out to me. Several episodes ago, we had McCoy state that, or Spock state, one of two of them, I can't remember who, said something along the lines of that the starship is the best cure for a woman, referring to Kirk's love of the ship over his love for a woman. Well, we get the exact opposite of that here, and Kirk becomes smitten with this woman who doesn't know how she got on board the Enterprise, doesn't know anything about her past, and Kirk is all about her, yet his entire crew is missing. Hello? This is Kirk. This is the guy we just set up as he will do anything for his ship, but nope, they're all gone. Doesn't really matter, but here's this beautiful woman. Let me start making out with her. Dumb writing. Then we have all the stuff between Spock and the Gideons, who refuse anybody to transport down to their planet for negotiations, and we get just minutes of dull, drolling dialogue between Spock and their chairman, chancellor, president, king, whatever he is. And it's not even interesting. It's not witty Spock. It's not Spock trying to outsmart him. It's just Leonard Nimoy talking, and it's really boring. None of the other characters contribute much to anything. I think Sulu looks at something once. Uhura says something. Scotty says something about the transporters and gets upset. Bones makes a couple comments. Like, it was nothing. None of the other characters were developed. But the real problem lies in this is not well thought out science fiction. And we've seen this in not just Star Trek episodes, but other bad science fiction in general, that the people who watch it just start punching holes in it because nothing makes sense. It's not well constructed, and that's what this is. Basically, their planet has become so overpopulated because they reach this utopian state where they will basically live forever and they're at their spiritual high. Okay, that was interesting, but because they kept living and nobody died, their population grew out of control and they're overpopulated. That is interesting. I like that idea. I think you could have done a whole lot with that. That's very reminiscent of almost like a Philip K. Dick sort of thing I could see happening. But they don't develop it well. In fact, it's the opposite. They develop it really poorly because when we do get to see these people, and by the way, Kirk didn't actually transport to another dimension. He transported down to their planet, and they had a mock-up of the Enterprise that he was on to make it appear vacant. But when we see their population, they are literally pressed together like cattle. And we're supposed to be believing that the entire planet is like this. The girl that he meets, she talks about how their greatest hope and their greatest wish is to be alone, and they don't know what it means to be alone. I like that idea, but again, when we actually get to see it, it is so ridiculous. They all wear these unitards with hoods, and they literally just kind of bump into each other and move around, and that's it. Let's just think about this for a moment. Their population is that large, yet they somehow have space to build a full mock-up of the Starship Enterprise. They talk about how they keep breeding, but nobody will use contraceptives because it's against their religious views. Is that social commentary towards the Roman Catholic Church? It's not very well constructed. It's very blatant, if that's what you're going for. And again, not even well thought out. So, my question is, okay, if they're breeding like that, where are they doing this? Where are they delivering these babies? Where's their food? If they are literally pressed in shoulder to shoulder, where are the farms that the food comes from? Wouldn't you have issues of starvation? I mean, at what point are these people going to start rioting? If you were cramped in that much for so long, don't you think they would start rioting and killing each other? Wouldn't they start dying out from starvation? Because we are told that they can die, but it takes this virus. Just not thought out. And that's the thing, is it just was so lazy. And I could sit here and I could go on for probably another 20 minutes and just point out all the dumb things about that concept of them living like that, but it's going to be a waste of everybody's time for me to do it. The other thing I want to talk about is that they want Kirk to get this virus out of his blood to give it to the people to help them die. These people are not willing to wear condoms, but they're willing to commit mass suicide. These people are unwilling to work with the Federation to control their population and come up with a new solution. But they're willing to execute their members of their society, so to speak. Or maybe it was supposed to be voluntary. I don't know. Their philosophy doesn't make sense. We're told almost nothing about their philosophy. But what we can gather from their actions based upon their philosophy as to how much they hold to it, it's not very sound. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense. This is just lazy writing at its best. Kirk is uninteresting. The girl is uninteresting. Everybody is uninteresting in this. Yes, Spock and McCoy are boring in this episode. This may be, I think this might actually go on my list of the worst, where "And the Children Shall Lead" had some interesting stuff in it. Spock's brain, as dumb as it was kind of fun at points, and there were some interesting things in it. Wolf in the Fold, as awful as the sexism was in that episode, there were some great things, like with the whole plot with Scotty. I can't find anything good in this one. I really can't. So, I don't know how you guys felt about this, how many of you have seen it, but let me know in the comments. So definitely please pass this stuff around. I'm coming to a close of season 3. I'm going to be guesting on a podcast next week for Heroes Sold separately to talk about Trek Year and to talk about the new movie Into Darkness, which I saw yesterday. I will be giving you my full review of that through the podcast. So check those guys out. I'll be putting a link to their stuff as well and promoting them a whole lot. And where I go from here, I am not sure. I will let you guys know in the next week as soon as I finish up season 3. So, Gideon, you suck.